Hey, welcome back to Skyblock. I am absolutely this right here is the goal today. I should be doing the spiders because I was told do the spiders so that I could get the string and get a bed. So I should probably also do that. I feel like today I have enough wood slabs. I had a stack and a quarter of logs. And I just turned them all into planks and turned all those planks into this. I also have another stack of logs sitting in the box over there. But I needed all of these. I think this is probably enough to build the platform out the way I want. So you know what? I'm going to frame it. Because that's normally what I would do in a construction project like this. I'd frame it so that I know exactly how it's supposed to look. It does feel like this is probably a little bit bigger than normal for framing, and being out here is very precarious, so probably didn't think about it because of how awful it would be if after all of the trees I had to sit and cut down, I just wasted all of that fucking lumber on dying in a hole. That does look like a decent spot to do something like build an actual house so that I can mark it off the damn list, because what I've currently got is not a house. There's no excuse to call that a fucking home of any kind. So I need to build a house, and I think doing that over in this section might be a sensible thing to do. At a certain point, I was going to stop building with these wood slabs, and I was going to move over to just using cobblestone ones, but I did sitting there and digging all of that cobblestone out with how long it takes me to fucking do that. It feels like such a waste, and I always have to save a certain amount of cobblestone. Like, I'm gonna use an axe probably, I'm gonna use a sword, and I'm gonna use a pickaxe. So I need to have 8 cobblestone just sitting there that I'm not gonna use for anything except for a replacement tool. And then I need to replace that tool and then dig out 3 more or 2 more just to make sure I've got it all. I'm hoping my Kevin McAllister caliber trap over there fucking works tonight. Those bastards are going to come back and fly down at me, and probably I'm going to have to fucking sprint back over there because I can already see the fucking sun setting under my feet. Feels very odd to me. You know, it's weird. I've never had this before, but over the last, like, year, 2 years, something like that, I've had, there's a joke in games like Dragon Age where dwarves come up out of the mines and they fear that they're going to fall into the sky, that they're going to fall up into the sky. And it's always a joke. It's haha, very funny, stupid dwarves think they're going to fall into the fucking sky. I've been fucking having that, not like a legitimate fear, but my brain reacting to looking up into the sky has been, I'm going to like get pulled up off the ground and fall into the sky. No idea why that's happening. Never happened to me before. I've been an adult for a very long time at this point, and as a kid, that never fucking occurred to me. So it feels very odd to me to feel that way. Wait, do I have to worry about them today? Didn't I die last time? Didn't they kill me? They're not supposed to show up, are they? Maybe I get a bit of a reprieve. It's not till approaching this tiny little gap with what I have left of my oak slabs that I really thought about how big this fucking gap was. I used so many fucking wood slabs. Because I didn't just have the full hot bar down at the bottom filled, except for the sword, that was in the way. I didn't just have all of those spaces filled. I had multiple spaces in my inventory that just had these on them. It feels very weird to have all of that space taken up and to see it all gone faster than I had suspected I would go through them all. I kind of joked in my head, like, this is overkill, this is way more than I need, but it was actually pretty fucking close to exactly how much I still needed. God damn, that's ridiculous. I have this birch sapling and I hadn't used it yet. I need to get more birch saplings, I think. I'm not 100% sure on that. It's not in my goals list. Not something that's necessary, but it is something that I suspect I should have. I really don't have enough dirt left to do pretty much any of the stuff I was hoping to. I really wanted to have like a bigger area, because this is not big enough for things to... This is not big enough for like sheep and cows and pigs and stuff like that to spawn on. And don't know that I really want to be doing anything crazy. I built that out, so that's what I actually wanted to get done today. I could make the platform outside of this platform like normal blocks. I could start making everything into normal blocks. Then I could make wooden fence posts like I did back in Sky Factory, put torches on top of the fences, and that way I've got like a clear design for the lighting. Because I can put that lighting, like, put one, skip five or six spaces, and then put another one. If I skip five spaces, then there'll be, in the middle, there won't be any problem. But if I skip more than that, there's always, like, a problem in the middle. Well, hell, that one actually grew pretty fast. It didn't take very long. Now I just need to hope that I get more birch saplings out of it. Because if I don't get more birch saplings out of it, then this will have just been me getting a couple of logs that I probably didn't need to be this particular color. Good. I got one. I ain't replanting that. I'm not going to plant another one. There we go. Okay. I can keep doing this. I want the aesthetic of everything to be the same concept. So I don't want to do something like start making birch planks and then laying them down next to each other, because that sort of patchy looking thing would bother me. But what I normally do when it comes to something like this, I set it on fire and I just make it all charcoal, since I definitely need lots of charcoal to keep things going for various different things here. Be a good idea for me to have that. Finally got that. I can consider that a sugarcane farm. It is making sugarcane in all 10 of the spaces that are available for it. And if I were going to make a small, like, basic farm, something like this, I'd probably want to have at least 9-10 spaces. I mean, I could obviously expand this, but I don't need to right now. I am going to mark it off my fucking list, because I don't need to expand it at all, realistically, for it to make sense for what it is. Trying to kick this up a gear and make sure that I actually get things accomplished, because, like, ooh, Red got a fucking sugarcane farm going. That's not at all fantastic or special. Going to the Nether was a bigger deal than that. And oh, crazy, you got a fucking platform built. None of that's anything. So I want to do something that I can mark a thing off with that actually makes some sense. So I think I'm going to build a house. Man, I heard about this. I don't like that wheat is not clearly grown. Like, this looks very different than the stages that came right before it. There. Okay, the wheat, it actually was grown. But a minute ago, it looked similarly quite grown. And it was not. Because the last time it was like that, I tried breaking it to get wheat, and it didn't come out. It just gave me seeds. So I'm not a huge fan of the change because it's not obvious. It's not so much about, like, realism or anything, because I don't care too much about that. It's purely the fact that if I can't look at it and easily distinguish that this thing is different from that thing, it's going to end up being a bit of a problem for me to inspect it. You know, it's fantastically strange, but every fucking one of those slabs that I've broken, I've picked back up. I organized this as a 9x9, so I broke the 16 on the sides and this one corner for a 17. That's crazy that they didn't just fall out of the world. I didn't exactly need them back. I'm growing plenty of trees, but it's still pretty cool that I didn't lose any of them in the fucking hole. So far, I've caught every single one of these damn things, so I'm not going to even try anymore to pick them up. I'm going to crouch over these, and I'm just going to let them fall because I don't actually have to care about them. So I'm cool with letting them fall into the void. I need a platform that I can build a house on, and me not dropping these was becoming a distraction from me actually building a fucking house. These I'm not sure about. I was thinking about the pumpkin and melon farm idea. Like, they're supposed to grow out of the dirt like this, and they seem like they're the right size and the right color. And if I F3 and check on them, I can see that their age is set to 7. So those are fully grown. They just don't seem to be producing anything. So wonder if I've done something wrong in planting them. I was never particularly good at planting pumpkin and melon farms in Skyblock. I always screwed it up. And right now, they're fully grown. You know something? One of the issues with me playing this is just the fact that processes take such a long time. I built the frame for my house, and I built the floor. And all that is a raised platform of wood planks. I built the platform that heads out to that as well. And I throw that in there. I built all of that, and that took me a lot of time. It probably shouldn't have. This is not to say, like, I mentioned it already. God, you know, and I put back the fucking pickaxe because I didn't think I was going to screw up like that. This probably shouldn't have taken me as long as it did. But it did take me a long damn time today. I have already been recording for over 40 minutes. And all I've done is build this platform and build the foundation, the wooden foundation of a fucking house. I also don't have enough cobblestone on me right now to finish building this damn house. It's got to be that tall at the very least. So let me frame the roof of it real quick. I am going to have to put a door in right there. I'll probably put windows in. So if I do put windows in, then it's acceptable for me to have these gaps in the middle. Just need to have that. And I don't even have enough cobblestone to frame that. So I guess what I need to do is use a bunch of the stuff that I've got sitting over here. I did forget entirely that I have this building right here. This building needs to get torn down because I really just need the fucking water thing on the side of it to be here. The rest of it I don't need to keep. So I'm going to tear this down. I kind of want to do cobblestone slabs as the roof again, just to make it so I don't have to light it up and nothing can spawn up there and then drop down on me. And I broke that. Well, it's a good thing I saved some cobblestone. Okay. I put my slabs in up there. And they're not on the the bottom half of a block. They're on the top half. So I'm not sure if that's going to keep things from spawning. I don't know. I'm pretty sure they're not allowed to spawn on slabs regardless. I'm not 100% sure on that, though. And it makes me hesitant to sort of leave it there, give it that space. Kind of have to, because I've now been going for over 50 minutes. And I have built a house. I finished out my platform. I also harvested wheat. Not exactly a goal that I was like specifically aiming for, but I did do something. I feel like this thing, that again doesn't look like it's the right fucking thing. I feel like with this farm being accomplished and me marking that off and the house being done, I can mark that off now. I'd love to have some glass, but I'm not. Oh, I hear those motherfuckers. I heard you. I'm running. You bastards. I don't think these cactus are helping me all that much. Definitely got hurt, though. And I don't know if it can fit between the blocks. Probably ought to test that now. It's not going to kill me to get hit once. But if they swoop down and they hit the cactus, then they get hurt. If they swoop down and hit me, I'll at least know they can. They're a bit wide. Looks to me like it might be possible for them to hit me. But right now, they're not doing a very good job of it. That's actually good enough for me at the moment. I don't actually have to care all that much about it. I think with a house done and the sugarcane farm done, and I can swing at them while they're coming at me. With those finished, the only thing I really need to worry about is getting enough dirt to make the farms and also making a field big enough for like cows and pigs and shit to spawn. Because that's like another major goal I need to work towards. I didn't make the mob spawner. I wasn't exactly planning on making it. I was just hoping that that would be a possibility. Thought maybe I ought to try it, and I didn't. So, I guess that means I'm done for the day. I'm gonna kill these motherfuckers, and then I'm gonna probably go and chop down that fucking tree that I just saw over there. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.